This is the Gaza you don't see, part two. Last week, I showed you the factual reality of what the Gaza Strip actually looks like. Ever since the Strip has really existed, people have regularly referenced it as a ruined plot of land with the most densely populated area on Earth, with nearly 2 million people. It's reputed to be a dump, a place without any real advancement or any wealth within the community. But last week, I showed you what the actual state, what it actually looks like in Gaza. The state far from the one the majority of the world has been brainwashed to think for almost two decades. The cars, the restaurants, the mansions, the coastlines, the wealth, the bling. What do they call it again? Oh, right. The world's largest open-air prison. What would you tell me in this moment if you found out that this footage is from right now? Ask yourself that question, because right before the war started, this is what the Gaza Strip looked like. The problem is that nobody in mainstream media has told you that. You didn't know otherwise, and that isn't your fault, but the false narrative that has been played out almost to a perfection. Has everyone across the world, even some of Gaza's neighbors, including Israel, confused and brainwashed too? The thing is, Gaza is not a Hollywood apocalyptic film. Actually, let's stay on this for just one moment.
Day 1001. My name is Robert Neville. I'm a survivor living in New York City.
That is apocalyptic. That is the destruction of the world. That is catastrophic. But $100,000 cars don't belong in an open-air prison. Villas on the beach and coastline with state-of-the-art marble and design don't belong in an open-air prison. Professional chefs with fancy dishes and dining venues don't belong in an open-air prison. You know, it's all pretty crazy to me, because if you take a look a little bit deeper under the hood, all of this information and all of these answers are right in front of you. Understand if you really have to go, always against us. Niggas move extra, always wanna test us. I don't need a lecture. Countless times when I painted had me messed up. But through the storm, they be saying that I'm next up. Through my hallway, and then the people left us. Through the pain, it's like nobody. The people in Gaza promote this land in paradise. Influencers on Instagram and TikTok, YouTubers, content creators, models. Go into the content being created on these platforms and take a look for yourself at what the Gaza Strip actually looks like. And you're right, none of these are things that the mainstream media has ever and will ever show you. So you know what, while we're here together, let's take a look at a day in Gaza. For over 4 months, the IDF has been inside of the Gaza Strip. Before this war, they didn't step a foot in there. Not a grain of sand belonged to Israel. It has always been last on the list for the IDF to do, because they understand how much of a risk it is with the enemy that lives within. But after almost two decades, however, of the IDF not being present in Gaza, the soldiers in the Israeli army have been returning to Israel regularly after spending time deep inside of these cities, reporting more and more like apartments like the one you are about to see are much more prevalent than any of them formerly believed. This is not propaganda, and this is not fake news. This is interior design and renovations being done inside of the Gaza Strip. Once again, we are back to the same exact point. This video is showing the objective truth. This video is for truth seekers. The content you are seeing right now is coming from the place that everyone in the world is calling an open-air prison, the most densely populated place on Earth, a dump. But the evidence is right in front of you. The proof is right in front of you. These are not photoshopped images and footage to try and convince you otherwise. These are Gazans inside of Gaza showing you what their life is like in Gaza. there really isn't anyone better to hear from in the world if you want to know more about what Gaza looks like. And now you do. Many claim that Israel is to blame for the so-called poverty in Gaza, but they left the Strip in 2005, and they haven't had any presence there since the beginning of this war. So, does that mean that Israel is also responsible for all of the wealth and affluence that is currently present in the Gaza Strip? And for all of the unequal distribution of resources? How is it that bags of flour and cartons of water don't make it to the citizens who need them? The humans. I thought it was called humanitarian aid. Comment below if this video changed your mind about Gaza. And share this video to share the truth.